Morning students, I hope all of you are keeping well. Be at home and be safe. Now in the previous class I had told you to read the chapter The Best Christmas Present in the World. I hope all of you have read the chapter. Now let us have a look at the important parts of the story. First, the roll top desk. The author wanted to have a roll top desk, but since he was not able to buy the new one, he did not have that much money. He decided to buy a second hand roll top desk, and he found a roll top desk in a junk shop. It was in a bad condition, but he could afford that, and so it could be repaired. And so he decided to buy this damaged roll top desk. As many times we want to have something, and when we don't able to buy the new one, so we go for the second hand, like maybe like car, bike, or anything. So same way, the author also wanted to have a roll top desk, and since he could not afford the new one, so he bought a second hand one from a junk shop. Now, after bringing it to home, he started repairing that roll top desk, and he started taking out everything part by part. He pulled out the drawers. He found that these had been badly damaged by fire and water. This roll top desk was damaged by fire and water. So this water came from where? We had already seen, if you have read, you know, this the house of Koni was burnt, and this roll top desk was there, and maybe to extinguish the fire, the water was used, and because of that, the fire and water had damaged this roll top desk. And the man who sold it had told him that it was very old. It was of 19th century and made of oak. See, this roll top desk was very old. It was made of oak wood. And he started taking out the drawers one by one. The last drawer was stuck fast. He had to use much force to open it. And when he opened it, there was a secret space, and in it he found a small tin box, and on the tin box, on the top of that, something was written. And what was written? Jim's last letter received January 25th, 1915. In the previous day, I had told, see, Jim MacPherson is a British army officer, and he was in the battlefield, and he had written a letter to his wife to share his experience of the celebration of Christmas with enemy soldiers. So Christmas is celebrated in December 25th. See, on 25th December every year Christmas is celebrated. So he might have written after that, but this letter was received by Connie MacPherson on 25th January 1915, and something more had been written on that: to be buried with me when the time comes. She wanted that letter to be buried with her. Inside there was an envelope with the address: Mrs. Jim MacPherson, 12 Copper Bridges, Bridport. The date was December 26, 1914. So in the envelope, the address of Mrs. Jim MacPherson was written, and the date which was mentioned was December 26, 1914. So maybe 25th they had celebration of Christmas, and he had written this letter on 26th. Now, the author wanted to read that letter. So he read that letter. The owner of the desk must have put it in it. The letter had been written by a captain of the English army. His name was Jim McPherson. He had written it to his wife, Connie. A wonderful incident had happened on the battlefield on the Christmas day. Jim McPherson had narrated it in his letter. So, after reading that letter, the author came to know that this letter was written by one of the British Army officer, Jim McPherson, and that letter was all about the experience he had while celebrating Christmas with enemy soldiers, and that he had shared with his wife, Connie McPherson. In that, some of the unforgettable moments were there. Jim McPherson narrated the incident. The English and Germans were at war. In the beginning itself, I had told there was English army and German armies were in the battlefield. The two armies stood in their respective trenches on the two sides of the no man's land. Other day we discussed the trenches. Trenches is hiding places where these both the armies were hiding in their own trenches in no man's land. Suddenly, McPherson saw someone waving a white flag from the enemy side. Then he saw many German soldiers calling out to them. They were wishing a happy Christmas to the English soldiers. So in the beginning, McPherson saw one of the German soldier waving a white flag. White flag is the symbol of peace. So one of the German soldiers was waving this white flag, and other soldiers were shouting happy Christmas, or maybe wishing them Christmas. And then some English soldiers shouted back, same to you. So they also greeted back, they also wished them back. The English thought that was all. To their surprise, they saw many Germans moving towards them. The captain was alarmed. It could be a trick. So after wishing each other, English thought maybe that was all and that everything was over. But they were surprised to see that German soldiers were moving towards them. And seeing this, Jim McPherson was alarmed because he thought maybe it could be a trick. But it was not. They were bringing with them German wine and cane meat. Now there were no rifles between the soldiers. They were hugging one another. And in the beginning, Jim McPherson thought maybe it was a trick. But they did not have rifles, they did not have guns, and they were having some wine and cane meat and some eatable things. And so when they reached, they greeted each other, they hugged each other, they wished happy Christmas to each other. The German officer moved towards McPherson. So they had also a captain. So he wanted to see the captain of enemy soldiers, and he is Jim McPherson. They shook hands very warmly. Then the German officer said that he was from Dusseldorf and that he played cello in the orchestra. He gave his name as Hans Wolf. So German captain came to Jim McPherson. He introduced himself as Hans Wolf, and as I had discussed in the previous class, I had told Hans Wolf was a cello player in the orchestra before he joined the army. And in return, Jim McPherson also gave his introduction, and he said that he was a school teacher before he joined the army. Now both of them were talking, and while talking, they talked many things, about many things. Hansford smiled. He said he knew Dorset. As you know, Jim McPherson was from Dorset, and so Hansford said that he knew Dorset. In fact, he had never been to England. He said he had never been to England, but he said he knew Dorset. But how? But he knew English. His favorite writer was Thomas Hardy. His favorite book was Far From the Madding Crowd. It was from there. He had learned all about Dorset. So, you know, many times we learn about the places from the book. Though we have not visited the places, but by reading books, we come to know about the places, about the things of that places. So same way, Hans Wolff also had not visited Dorset, but he had come to know about Dorset from the book of Thomas Hardy. Thomas Hardy is a well-known writer, novelist. So he, this Hans Wolff, read his book and he came to know about Dorset. Macpherson shared with Hans Wolff the Christmas cake his wife had sent for him. Hans Wolff said that the marzipan was the best he had ever tasted. It was a wonderful Christmas party. And so Macpherson had a cake which Connie Macpherson had sent him, and he shared with Hans Wolff, and both of them enjoyed. Now, other soldiers, they were also talking to each other. They were enjoying Christmas. Then one of the soldiers, he brought a football. The soldiers played while Macpherson and Hans Wolff clapped and cheered. So this is one of the way to celebrate Christmas. They played football, and two teams, maybe one team is British soldier, another team is German soldier, and both the captains, they just they were cheering them. Hans Wolff suggested that the world war would be much better if the problems were resolved by a football match instead of war. So this was the opinion of Hans Wolff. Actually, nobody wants war. Even Jim Macpherson also did not like war. But since both of the countries, they were against each other, they had to show their patriotism towards their country, and so they had to fight. But as a human, they did not like war. And that is why Hans Wolff said, the world would be much better if the problems were resolved by a football match. So this is the picture you can see. Now, the celebration. This slide is not very clear. Yeah. So the celebration. After the football match, all the drinks and eatables were consumed. Now it was time to part. Hans Wolff saluted Macpherson and walked away slowly and unwillingly. See, after the celebration, they parted from each other, but unwillingly. They did not want to fight. And so, though even if they did not want, but they had to obey their country, they have to show their patriotism to their country. And so, unwillingly, they departed from each other and they went back to their own trenches. That night, Germans were heard singing a carol. The English soldiers replied with a rousing chorus of another carol. So that night, Germans, after going to their trenches, the whole night they sang carol. See, what is carol? Carol is actually the Christmas song which is sung in a group. So whole night they sang these Christmas songs, and in reply, English soldiers also sung in their trenches. They exchanged carols for a while and then it was all silence. After some time, this everything was quiet and they all were quiet. There was silence. So MacPherson wrote in his letter that he would treasure those moments all his life. So it was really a wonderful moment, and that Jim MacPherson wants to remember that in his life all the times. So MacPherson ended the letter hoping that the war would end soon. Both armies longed for peace and he was sure they would be together again. So MacPherson, there was a hope that this war will get over soon and they all will go to their own houses, their own and see their own family members. Now, so that was all about the letter which was written by Jim MacPherson. After reading this letter, the author wanted to deliver this letter to its owner. That means to Connie MacPherson. And he decided to give the letter back to whom it belonged. That means to its owner. And that is why he saw the address which was given on that letter, and that was Bridport, Dorset. And he went there. But after going there, he found the address which was given on that. There was a burnt house. That means the house of which the address was given on the letter was burnt. It was found that Mrs. MacPherson was in the house when it caught fire, and he came to know that that Mrs. MacPherson was in the house at that time, and she had been rescued by a fireman, and her age was 101 year old, and now she was in a nursing home. So at least that information the author got, that he was 101 year old and she was in a nursing home. Now author went to the nursing home. He met the matron there and he talked about Mrs. MacPherson. Then afterwards he was told that Mrs. MacPherson was rather confused that day, and that is why they had put her in a conservatory. Conservatory is like a glass house. And then author went to her, and when he went to her, she looked up at the author vacantly. That means she could not recognize maybe. And already we saw that she was 101 year old. Her eyes lit up when he called her Connie and gave her the letter. See, when she heard her name called by someone, her eyes were lit up. He told how he had got the letter, but she was not listening to him. The author told everything, all the incident, how he got the letter, but she was not listening to him at all. She reached out and took his hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. She felt that her Jim had returned. She said that her Jim had kept his promise. He had returned on the eve of Christmas. So that is what, see, now though the author told everything, but she did not listen anything, and she thought that her husband has come back, as he had promised her that he would come back on the eve of Christmas, and he has kept his promise. She made him sit beside her. She kissed him his cheek. She talked long and lovingly to him. She said that she had got the best Christmas present in the world. Now, she was very happy. She kissed him, thinking that he was her husband. And she even told that she had got the best Christmas present in the world. So now what could be the best Christmas present? Was it the person, the author, or the letter? So just think about that and find out. You can see some of the pictures here. And I hope you have understood the chapter. If you have any difficulty, any problem, you can write to me in my personal WhatsApp, or you can ring up to me. Okay, thank you. Keep well.